Another Chamber of Commerce afternoon in America's finest city, and a great day to be outdoors to take in recreation of your choice. Across the Coronado Bridge to the park in the park, just outside Petco, Team Puerto Rico has already qualified to move on in the tournament, and at Petco Park today, their final tune-up before the semifinals. Welcome to this World Baseball Classic telecast on MLB Network, presented by Geico. This afternoon, our first of two at Petco Park, featuring semifinalists Puerto Rico and the All-Stars from Venezuela. It's the last day of pool play here in San Diego. A doubleheader on tap today. Puerto Rico has already qualified to move on. They match up with Venezuela in the early game today, and then later tonight, the Dominican Republic battles the U.S. to determine who else moves on to Los Angeles. With that, we welcome you inside the broadcast booth. The start of a long day of baseball here. John Smoltz, Matt Vaskersian, J.P. Morosi in a moment. This has a different feel than the games played so far in the tournament.
It does. Puerto Rico, of course, wants to finish strong. They would love to keep winning, right? They're going to go on to L.A. Venezuela, for the pride factor, wants to check in and get a win. I think the guys on Venezuela will go through a spring training type game, give their best effort, and then know they're going to go back to their respective teams.
Let's check the starting pitching matchup for Puerto Rico's final tune-up before they head to L.A. for the semifinals. Venezuela, as John mentioned, would love to get on the books with a win before this team is broken up and redistributed to the Grapefruit and Cactus Leagues. Martin Perez, the Rangers left-hander, will try to accomplish that for them. Jose De Leon for Puerto Rico.
Yeah, both guys are going to establish themselves as they would, getting ready for the season. They're going to be their last starts in World Baseball Classic pool play. I think for Martin Perez, try to give him five innings. Try to give your best effort. The Venezuelan team obviously limping in here with some injuries, and if they can get a great pitching performance, maybe they can get that win.
Puerto Rico's lineup has been outstanding. In Jalisco, Mexico, here in San Diego, they're giving one of their stars the afternoon off because Francisco Lindor will be an important player for them in Los Angeles moving forward in this tournament. His 2 years of Major League Baseball experience, he's already established himself as one of the premier players in the sport.
He's fantastic. He's electric. He's what you want to see if you're coming to the ballpark, because he can do it all, defensively, offensively. Cleveland, so glad they have him. And he's going to have a few more games to play.
How's he feeling about the WBC so far? J.P. Morosi is with him to find out.
Thanks, Matt. Here with Francisco Lindor. And Francisco, you've beaten the Dominicans. You've beaten the Americans. Is this the best team in the world right now?
We haven't won anything yet, so I don't want to say we're the best team in the world. We're up there. But we're taking things day by day, and we just focus and try and play the game the right way, and we'll see what happens. You know, the Dominicans are the defending champs, so technically right now they're still the world champs, so we'll see what happens. I got a lot of confidence in my team. I believe in my team. I believe in my teammates, and we're doing something good.
Semifinal showdown Monday against the Dutch at Dodger Stadium. How can today help you prepare for that game?
We just got to make sure we, you know, this game doesn't really, it means some, but it doesn't really mean that much, because we're already in L.A., you know. But the way we play today is going to continue to help us to understand that we got to take every inning the right way, every pitch the right way, and not take anything for granted. So we preparing that way. That way, when we come to L.A., everything counts. Everything counts in one game. That's it.
Gracias, fuerte.
Gracias.
Matty, back to you.
JP, thanks. Puerto Rico ready for their final tune-up before the semifinals, and we're ready for our first of two from Petco Park this afternoon. Coming up, the lineups and the opening pitch, Puerto Rico and Venezuela are next. Boy, Team Puerto Rico is just loaded with talent.
Lindor, shortstop, by second base. Correa is going to be playing third base.
They've got the most electrifying infield perhaps the entire tournament.
You're talking about not just elite defenders. They do magic tricks with their gloves on the field.
That's barely humanly possible.
Oh, baby, what a play.
You're giving a glimpse of what Puerto Rico is all about. The way we play the game, that spark, it's like hot sauce.
Well, the stars of Puerto Rico are all set against Venezuela left-hander, the 25-year-old Texas Ranger, Martin Perez. Puerto Rico knows they've already qualified to advance in the tournament. Here's what it looks like headed to Los Angeles with one piece of business yet to be determined. The first semifinal matchup at Dodger Stadium, the Kingdom of the Netherlands against this Puerto Rico squad. And then whoever wins tonight, that is, between the U.S. and the Dominican Republic, will draw one of the heavy favorites in the tournament, Japan, in the other semifinal. And it all leads into that championship match Wednesday, March 22nd in L.A. So Puerto Rico ready for what amounts to a tune-up start this afternoon, our first of two at Petco Park today. And let's take a look at Edwin Rodriguez's starting lineup. He really gives it most of his regulars here, given the low stakes. Mike Aviles has not played so far in San Diego. The veteran right-handed hitter's in right field, batting number six. Rene Rivera's at first base. Roberto Perez will make his first appearance in San Diego as well. Catch, Carlos Correa continues to be one of Puerto Rico's leaders. He's reached base safely in all five games in the tournament. And as mentioned, it is the veteran left-hander Martin Perez on the mound for Venezuela.
Yeah, Martin Perez primarily going to throw a lot of fastballs. Over 60% fastballs, and the rest is going to be split up between changeup, sliders, and curveballs. So look for him to establish his fastball and then work with his off-speed against this lineup.
A 10-11 record last year as a Ranger, made 33 starts for Texas, logged in an ERA at 4.39 in a full season in the Rangers rotation. Underway this afternoon, Angel Pagan takes a ball on the inside. Pagan has led off and played left field throughout the tournament for Puerto Rico. And the veteran switch hitter has a base hit into the corner. He'll cut the bag and head into second with a leadoff double this afternoon.
Well, for Martin Perez, here's the factors for today's game. Tune up for the season. This will be more in line with him rejoining his team after this. Be aggressive with the fastball, point number two, and then use all of your off-speed. This is where you can really fine-tune and work on things without the pressure of having to win a game since they are eliminated. I would think that he would want to get every pitch he's got going in today's game.
That'll bring up the right-handed bat of Kike Hernandez, starting at shortstop in this one today. Hernandez giving Francisco Lindor the day off. Lindor, of course, visiting with J.P. Morosi before the game. Not willing to say, John, that this is the best team in the world quite yet.
Yeah, you can't. You can't say that.
They're two wins away from that.
Yeah.
Well, for whoever wins this thing on Wednesday, the inevitable question will be asked shortly thereafter. Are you the best team in the world? Are you better than the defending World Series champs? I'm sure the folks around Wrigley Field would have their thoughts on that. A ball and a strike to count to Kike Hernandez. He knows how good the Cubs are firsthand. He and the Dodgers falling to the Cubs in last year's NLCS. Ball and two strikes.
Up into this game, your mindset is to be as good as you can be as a player. No one wants to go out and look bad or not execute. Conversely, in spring training, your mindset's to get ready for the season. If you give up seven runs, you give up seven runs. Part of the process. Doesn't count, so they say. Puerto Rico, they've been unblemished in this WBC so far. And they seem to have the most passion and concentration to get to LA, which they're going. It starts and ends with the middle infield. Those guys are pretty incredible.
Edwin Rodriguez puts together a veteran coaching staff once again in this year's running of the tournament. Undefeated this year. It's two balls and two strikes to Kike Hernandez. Takes a little time to pull some pine tar tape off the handle of his bat. Three balls and two strikes. And Hernandez sends a flare out to right. That's going to drop in. Runners at the corners to start the afternoon.
Well, defensively, Team Venezuela, they're missing a couple stars, but the guys that are out there, still pretty good. Solarte's playing left, and Ciarte's playing center. Gonzalez, mainstay in right. Altuve's moved over to third with Odor at second. Escobar at short. Perez, both at the mound and at first base. Chirinos behind the plate.
Yeah, the Venezuela defense, their lineup without some of the firepower that they began the tournament with. Miguel Cabrera, after his matchup with the U.S. earlier this week, was returned to Tigers camp. Stiff lower back, no real injury concerns there. He is not expected to miss much time. Martin Prado with a hamstring injury that he suffered here at the beginning of the tournament, he was returned. Carlos Correa. And of course, Sal Perez injured in Mexico last week. And what was at the time thought to be a bit more serious than it turned out to be, fortunately for the tournament, fortunately for Venezuela, fortunately for the Kansas City Royals, Perez is expected to be eligible and okay to play on opening day. 0-2, the count to Carlos Correa. Yeah, these are high-profile names, folks, and this one was scary. Ironically, Drew Butera, who's Sal Perez's backup catcher in Kansas City, was the guy on the other end of that collision. This was Martin Prado here the other night, trying to leg out a ground ball, pulled up with a hamstring strain. And then we talked about Cabrera removing himself from the game a couple of nights ago here as well.
Come up.
Ball and two strikes to Carlos Correa. You know, when this tournament began, Venezuela was considered among the favorites. Some frontline major league starting pitching. Anytime you can stack up Victor Martinez and Miguel Cabrera 3 and 4, you're going to open some eyes. But it turned into a disappointing round here in San Diego.
Well,
JP, kind of makes you wonder what if they had their full complement of players available for the whole tournament.
Very good point, Maddie. And Omar Vizquel told me earlier today before the game, hey, we've got no excuse here. We got the star players we wanted, maybe didn't hit as well as they thought. And Matt, I'd make this point. The last two WBCs, Venezuela has not beaten a team from this hemisphere. Their only wins are against Spain and Italy twice this
wow.
year.
Here's the 2-2 home to Correa. Full count now, and Martin Perez is a miss away from loading the bases with nobody out. Kenny's Vargas, the switch hitting DH, waiting on deck. He'll be making his first appearance here in San Diego.
Yeah, for Perez, you don't want this to be an extended, really long inning. You'd like to get some outs, even if you trade some runs.
The payoff pitch. Ball four, and they are in fact loaded to start the afternoon.
Puerto Rico's been here in less than, what do we got, 12 hours? Base is loaded. Nobody out again.
Yeah, the same way it started yesterday, when Puerto Rico stacked up six straight hits to open the first inning against Marcus Stroman and the Americans. And we'll have an early visit now. You know, the base on balls have been an issue for Martin Perez in his career. His walks per nine last year, the sixth highest rate in the American League. Big Braw, number two, 76 walks in his less than 200 innings of work. And there they go, bullpen guys. Starting to feel more and more like a Cactus League game all the time. If we see guys doing wind sprints on the outfield track, I don't know what I'll think. So here's Kenis Vargas now, making his first World Baseball Classic appearance here in San Diego. 47 games with the Big League Twins last year, split a season between AAA Rochester and the Major League level. He combined to hit 25 home runs between the two stops. Still has an opportunity to win the full-time DH role in Minnesota this year. Behind 0-2. You know, so far the Twins, who have opened eyes with the quality of prospect that they've developed, haven't been able to get that player to star at the major league level yet. And maybe today's the, or maybe this year's the year for Byron Buxton, for Miguel Sano, Jose Berríos.
Yeah, they need that, because last year was just an awful start to the season. Of course, they really were not competitive.
And Vargas is retired on strike three.
This pitch on the outer part of the plate. Vargas. It definitely was in the outer part for a ball.
So here's TJ Rivera now. 1-for-14 in the tournament. His big league career got underway last season with 33 games in Flushing, Queens. He talked yesterday about how his setup reminds you of Alex Rodriguez.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll double down on that. From the neck up, he looks a lot like Alex Rodriguez. You're right about that setup, too. Rivera bounces it to shortstop. Puerto Rico loads the bases and does, in fact, get a run home. Rivera able to beat out the back end of the double play throw.
Good pitch. Ball just wasn't hit as hard as you needed it to turn two.
So now Mike Aviles. Aviles, one of the reserves on the Puerto Rico roster. This is his first appearance here in San Diego. He takes a strike. A versatile veteran player. Mike's one of the rather high profile free agents on this Puerto Rico roster. Games last year with the Tigers, and then was dealt to the Braves in mid-August. He was designated for assignment by Atlanta before even playing in a game. You got to believe there's a place where this guy could help you. Middle infield, he can play the corner. He can play all over the outfield. Slicing pop headed for the stands. And handled there. Fine play by Hernan Perez puts an end to the inning, and it could have been a whole lot worse for Venezuela. Puerto Rico loads the bases with nobody out and settles with one to start the day. Omar Vizquel's Venezuela lineup for their WBC finale. Ender Inciarte, Jose Altuve, and Rougned Odor lead things off. Victor Martinez, Carlos Gonzalez, and Alcides Escobar, 4-6. Yanhervis Solarte, the Padre, makes his first start here in San Diego. Hernan Perez and Robinson Chirinos round things up. Well, you might have thought that we'd see a little bit more of the bench player, the reserve out there for Venezuela, but they're without the kind of depth that they began the tournament with for the reasons we discussed. And it's really their big league players who are getting the opportunity here in the finale. And they're dealing with the outstanding young Dodger arm right-hander Jose De Leon. A wave and a miss, and De Leon makes quick work of Inciarte.
Well, for De Leon, I think it's going to be important to just ride the momentum. This team has a feeling that they're unbeatable. Why not keep it up? And then change it up. Use that changeup. Changeup is a good pitch for De Leon. And see if you can give him 5 innings just to not have to go through so many relievers. Even though they have a day off tomorrow, it'd be nice to get some innings.
I got my Jose De Leon's confused. This is Tampa Bay's Jose De Leon as I get my bearings straight here. There's the Logan Forsythe trade that made him Tampa Bay property. Still regarded as a top arm and one that the Dodgers were very reluctant to trade for quite a long time until they got the right price. He's ranked as a top 50 prospect in baseball, just 24 years old, 7-1 last year at AAA. And a strike to Jose Altuve. That's the cap that he should be wearing as I get myself together.
And as the Rays have done, they've got to have guys like that perform early in their careers.
Get on, get on.
Here we go. The only trouble he gets in is if he gets underneath. He gets the fastball down, but sometimes his elbow doesn't get in position and he gets underneath the ball. If you hear that term underneath, that means you're not pushing the ball, but not staying with the fingers on top and the elbow in proper plane.
Ball and 2 strikes to count to Jose Altuve.
Yeah, I just hung out with the family.
You know, remembering all the offers, or at least the reported offers that the Dodgers had for De Leon, it reminded you of the process they went through a few years ago when they had the opportunity to acquire Cole Hamels, and the asking price at the time was a little bit too high. Reluctant to deal Julio Urias, reluctant to deal Corey Seager, and now that we've seen those guys in the big leagues, we can understand why. And I would imagine that if De Leon gets that kind of opportunity in Tampa Bay, we'll understand a little bit more about the Dodgers' reluctance to deal him initially.
Ball.
2-2. Jose Altuve, as we've talked about, volunteering to play third base in this tournament and handling the position very well. Chasing here, and there are 2 gone.
There's that changeup I was talking about. Bottom dropped out of it. This pitch just. Well, for some of the players on Venezuela, they got some long trips back to their spring training sites. The ones that got to go to Florida, the ones who are in go to Arizona, piece of cake.
How about the guys that are going back to Venezuela?
Yeah.
Even longer still.
Yep.
Here's Rougned Odor now after a couple of strikeouts start the afternoon for De Leon. Odor back at his more organic second base spot again today. Played second base in one of the 2 previous games for Venezuela here. Had played some third in the tournament. Made a couple of errors against the U.S. That was not a great experiment for him, though I think he's to be credited for volunteering to move and change positions. a second base glut for Venezuela, the same way there was a little shortstop jam for Puerto Rico. Somebody has to move.
Oh, that was a good pitch right there.
Two balls and a strike to count to Rougned Odor.
I have no idea.
What? Routine fly ball into center field. Fuentes has it to retire the side. Three up, three down for Jose De Leon to start his afternoon. 1-0 Puerto Rico. This World Baseball Classic telecast on MLB Network is presented by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. And sponsored in part by Best Western Hotels and Resorts. Go get rewarded now at bestwestern.com. And by the all-new Alfa Romeo Giulia. Rene Rivera leads things off in the Puerto Rico half of inning number two.
I know why they didn't have me read that one.
Why?
That bottom line would have been tough.
The Giulia?
Yeah.
Yeah. A great day to be at the ballpark. A lot of folks come to stay at the park in the park and just casually take in a game here. A swing and a miss by Rivera, and it's 0-2. The big event's coming up tonight, folks. And a near sellout crowd is expected this evening. I believe there are still walk-up seats available for the U.S. and the Dominican Republic at 7 p.m. local time. We'll be on the air at 10 o'clock in the East. And the winner of that one moves on to Los Angeles for the semifinals and a date at Dodger Stadium.
It really is amazing here, though, the difference between this time frame in the next 2-3 hours and tonight.
That's into the gap in right center. And Rene Rivera's got extra bases to start the inning. You're talking about the way the ball plays?
Yeah, just I mean, you wouldn't think there'd be that big a difference in temperature and the ball and the way it carries, but this is as good as it gets right now. Pitching in this comfortable, get a little sweat. Hitters feel good. Tonight is going to be a different story.
High fastball and a relatively easy pickings for Rene Rivera. So back-to-back Puerto Rico hitters here who are making their first appearances in the tournament at Petco. Indians catcher Roberto Perez now. Can certainly understand Yadi Molina getting a day off today. It'll be crucial to their chances when this gets to Los Angeles on Monday. We remember Roberto Perez for his dramatic Game 1 World Series. Had a big night to open the Fall Classic for Cleveland. That's in foul territory and playable. Pagan is able to make the catch. Check that, rather. Solarte able to make the catch for out number one. Or Gonzalez even. I'll get it right. Hey, let's flash you back to that game one of the World Series. Roberto Perez had quite the night. Not one, but a pair of home runs.
Incredible moment for that young man.
Here's Raymond Fuentes now, 1-for-10 so far in the World Baseball Classic.
That's the challenge in these events for the managers. You got players that like to play and great players on these rosters all the way through, and not everyone's going to get the same timing and the same at bats.
Well, making it even harder is the fact that there are 30 teams that the World Baseball Classic managers are in large part accountable to. And those teams are not bashful when it comes to letting these managers know what they would prefer happen to their players. And I got to say that each of the managers in the tournament, we've spoken to each of them at length about this, they've been very diplomatic. They want to be as accommodating as possible, that, you know, keeping guys healthy is at the forefront of everybody's thoughts. They want to win, sure. And the hope is that the desire to win and fulfilling the wishes of the teams don't conflict. A swing and a miss by Fuentes. There are two gone here in the second.
But there is something special when you get to go and play for your country. And each person that talks about the opportunity, when they get wherever that pool is, they are having the time of their lives and certainly hoping their team can be crowned champion. There are some people that probably are not here watching some of these games going, man, I wish I would have said yes. And I'm sure there's some that just didn't have the opportunity for a variety of reasons.
Here's Angel Pagan now. He doubled and scored the game's first run back in the first inning. A 1-0 lead for Puerto Rico early on.
And tonight we'll tell that story in no better way than an elimination game between the U.S. and Dominican Republic.
It's going to be fun tonight. Atmosphere is going to be big time. High stakes. Two well-known major league starters on the mound. Danny Duffy for the U.S. Irvin Santana for Team Dominican Republic later tonight. The crowd begun and he swings and misses and wallet 1-2 now. Next half inning, we're going to talk a little bit about the teams that lie in wait, Japan and the Kingdom of the Netherlands. One, two for Perez. Pagan sends a rocket foul.
Really is one of the best settings for a baseball field. I mean, we always talk about the weather. The weather speaks for itself. But just the way it's set up and the opportunities for fans to not only see, as it looks like every seat's pretty good seat, the lawn area and just the buildings in the background, pretty cool.
Yeah, there's a nice level of intimacy here. Hard to believe this ballpark is almost 15 years old. And they continue to make it better all the time.
Now all they need is a winner.
Yeah. And they think that one might be coming. The Padres have spent a lot of money in Latin America the last year and a half. It's going to take a little while, but the plan is a few years down the road. They can start harvesting those contracts. Those players will be in the big leagues, and maybe they can compete with the Dodgers and Giants of the world. Two balls and two strikes on ex-Giant Angel Pagan. Sends a ball to the opposite field. Carlos Gonzalez has this one to retire the side. Nothing comes to the leadoff double. To the bottom of the second, 1-0 Puerto Rico. Welcome back to this World Baseball Classic telecast on MLB Network, presented by GEICO. A beautiful afternoon at Balboa Park throughout San Diego. Here at Petco Park, a 1-0 lead for Team Puerto Rico. Back with John Smoltz and JP Morosi, Matt Vasgersian. Victor Martinez leads things off for Venezuela in the second. Victor Martinez is one of the returnees to this event on Team Venezuela. And it's kind of unusual, JP, when you start thinking about the next time this event comes around. A lot of the players that have participated in it might not be active major leaguers at that point.
Very good point, Matt. And I spoke with Victor before the game. He's here today with his son, Victor Jose. They took pictures on the field before the game. So you really do sense, Matt, he knows this is probably his final game representing his country. I asked him, I said, Victor, maybe 4 years from now, you're going to play, manage? What do you think? He said, I think I'm going to be home.
I'm sure that sounds like a pretty good option for a guy that spent his entire life traveling in baseball, entering his 15th season in the majors.
Boy, he could hit.
Two and two. I remember talking about Victor Martinez with his manager, Brad Ausmus, a couple of years ago. And Brad, who makes his offseason home here in San Diego, he said, look, I've played with a lot of great hitters. He's played with some Hall of Famers. He's played with a couple of 3,000 hit guys. Tony Gwynn with Craig Biggio. He said he's never seen a player never take a pitch off the way Victor Martinez does. He's competitive on every pitch. And that might seem like a small detail, quite the opposite.
Yeah, he's locked in. He's one of the best RBI guys over the last 5-6 years from a productivity standpoint. I think it was 2 years ago he had a stretch where I think for the season he had struck out less than the times he, I mean, it was ridiculous. He just doesn't strike out that much 2 years ago, and really for the most part finds a way to put it in play, finds a way if there's a runner on third to get him in.
His 2014 season, and I had him as my MVP, of course I'm not a voter. His OPS was ridiculous. Twice as many walks as strikeouts, almost three times as many walks as strikeouts.
That's what it was.
974 OPS to lead the big leagues, and he hit 335. He's aboard to lead off the second. There's Carlos Gonzalez now. Carlos will be returned to the Salt River Training Complex in Arizona. He'll return to the Cactus League tonight and rejoin the Rockies. Have you been there to that facility?
I've driven by it and I've seen our network do a tour of it. It's supposed to be fantastic.
It's unreal. And Gonzalez has a base hit. So while Venezuela's team will be broken up at the conclusion of this game, Japan and the Kingdom of the Netherlands are still very much together. And JP, I want to bring you in on this because you're more versed in this than we are. What exactly are those teams doing to stay sharp? Has anybody gone back to their parent team and then will rejoin their WBC squad? Are they all together still?
Well, Matt, speaking of beautiful Salt River fields, that is where the Dutch team is as we speak. Just getting underway, the Dutch against the Diamondbacks, Cactus League ball with a WBC field today. At the same time, Team Japan playing at Sloan Park against the defending World Series champion Cubs. So both teams are now stateside getting ready for next week.
I like the idea, certainly for the Japanese team, because there's a lot to reacclimate themselves toward, like time zone, very basic things. They've got some big games coming up. They hope more than one. Semifinals start on Monday in Los Angeles. Runners aboard for Alcides Escobar.
All one.
JP, let's talk a little bit about Japan.
Well, we think, Matt, about the hit-and-run style, bunting, strong fundamentals, but this Japanese team, Matt, can hit the long ball better than those in the past. You see Sho Nakata, phenomenal run producer, as is Tsutsugo, who's a really big hitter in the middle part of that lineup. I'll also point out, Matty, I love this name, Ryosuke Kikuchi. He is basically Javi Baez of Japan, one of the best defensive second basemen in the world. I cannot wait to watch Kikuchi play second base.
Yeah, we feel the same way, too. There's something about the mystique around the Japanese team because they are not, let's face it, they are not familiar to us in large part. As powerful as the Dominican Republic lineup is, it's Japan that has led the tournament so far in runs scored and homers.
And Matty, as we think about Team Japan and the way they're playing, this tournament again, they have been the dominant team in this entire tournament's history, of course, going back to the championship in 06 right here at Petco Park, championship in 09 at Dodger Stadium, runner-up, or actually a semifinalist back in 2013. So again, they're the only team that's at least reached the semifinals every single time. And as we talk about the game tonight, Matt, this game tonight, USA against the Dominican, if the U.S. wins, then we'll see USA against Japan in the semifinals at Dodger Stadium. And that's the matchup, Matty, that we've talked about so much in the history of this tournament, but it's only actually happened twice, back in 06 and 09.
Yeah, I can't wait to watch that. I mean, regardless of who wins tonight between the U.S. and the Dominicans, that semifinal matchup with Japan is going to be appointment viewing. Here's Yanhervi Solarte now with one out, runners at first and second. Switch hitter in from the left side and trying to cash in on Martinez and Gonzalez, who reached to start the inning. A bouncing ball that'll find a hole. Bases are loaded with one away. Let's talk a little bit about the Netherlands team, JP. They're a much more household name big leaguers on that roster.
They are, yes. Again, with Japan, only Nori Aoki, the only major leaguer right now. And here you see the iron of the Netherlands lineup there with Ballantyne, who's had a great career in Japan. D.D. Gregorius now playing really all around the field, some DH as well. And Jurickson Profar, check out those numbers. He's actually playing left field for the Dutch. And on the far right of your screen, Kenley Jansen. My only question, Matt, Dodger Stadium, closing scenario, do they play California Love when it comes into the game? That's what I want to know.
I would hope they would. I mean, you know, the home guy closing out games in his home ballpark, unless there's some kind of a licensing issue or some ASCAP thing, play his song. Here's Hernan Perez now with a big opportunity, bases loaded and one away. It's the Kingdom of the Netherlands against Puerto Rico in their semifinal matchup coming up next week at Dodger Stadium. Again, the championship game on Wednesday. We'll be on the air all day, really, with expanded pre- and post-game coverage live from Dodger Stadium. Harold Reynolds bringing a huge, huge suitcase full of tapes.
I'll see DeRosa in the weight room working out.
0-1 the count to Hernan Perez. Jose De Leon got through the order in order in the first. Victor Martinez walked. Carlos Gonzalez singled to open the second. After an Escobar strikeout, Yanhervi Solarte singled. Bases are loaded with one away.
Got away with one there, breaking ball in the middle of the plate. This changeup, haven't seen as many of them I thought we would. Soto. Getting loose, you see that spinning right there. That one had an opportunity to do some damage, but Perez just pulled off just a hair.
Yeah. lined to shallow left. Pagan is on to make the catch. Tagging up is Martinez. Going to the plate. Got it. Boy, I was surprised to see Victor try to score on that. Martinez does not run like he once did. And it was relatively easy pickings for Pagan. Nothing despite a bases loaded opportunity. Play to pair. It's still 1-0 Puerto Rico. Here's your upcoming WBC schedule, and we don't want to get too far ahead of ourselves with the semifinals on Monday. The big one is tonight, folks. 10 p.m. Eastern, 7 o'clock local time, the U.S. and the Dominican Republic for the right to move on in the tournament. The loser goes home, the winner to L.A. Martin Perez back to work. Puerto Rico sends up Kike Hernandez to lead things off in their half of the third. Hernandez, Correa, and Vargas for Puerto Rico. High drive to center field. Routine for Ender Inciarte, a Gold Glover last year, and there is one away. Danny Duffy for the Americans tonight. Irvin Santana for Dominican Republic.
And every pitch will be high intensity. I can guarantee you that. Top step. Each player, each team. U.S. definitely wants to atone for the game they had well in hand.
There's a bolt out to left field that gets over the left fielder. Larkin really had no chance out there on that ball. Carlos Correa. A well-hit double.
So much power for this shortstop for the Astros. Low pitch. And this ball was on a rope. I mean, it was hit so hard that even the left fielder Solarte, who was trying to take the route to cut it off, was over his head. Blonde hair.
Yes. Here's Kenny's Vargas now. Puerto Rico has a double in each of the three innings they've opened in this one. The blonde hair has been something of a rallying cry for Team Puerto Rico. Peroxide crisis here in the county. Not a bottle to be found anywhere. It's a fashion statement that's been championed back on the island. There are t-shirts. There are imitators walking around. JP, did you track down the origin of this? Who started it?
Well, it began, of course, with Javi Baez wanting to go incognito in Chicago, maybe dyeing the hair a little bit. It's really caught on in Puerto Rico ever since then. So much so, Matt, that according to WAPA Television in Puerto Rico, a group of students at Colegio Sagrada Familia, a K-12 school in Corozal, they were suspended, Matt, upon arriving at school with their hair dyed blonde. Apparently, many schools in Puerto Rico have relatively strict grooming codes, and the actual Secretary of Education, Matt, of Puerto Rico, eventually came out and said, you know what, those suspensions were probably regrettable. The kids were just trying to have fun, Matt.
Having fun and supporting their baseball team. Yeah, the coaching staff's gotten into the act. Carlos Delgado, the great Toronto slugger, with a dyed blonde goatee, was probably the one that struck me the most. In addition to Carlos Beltran, who, as we said earlier in the tournament, has a striking resemblance to Ernest Hemingway. The blonde beard. Two balls and two strikes to Kenny's Vargas. That's the second time he has struck out this afternoon.
That's the hard part, you know, for guys that don't get enough at bats. To find that timing and feel like you're connected to getting ready for the season. Taking batting practice is one way, but tracking pitches live is what spring training provides for a lot of hitters.
Two way now for TJ Rivera.
Well, StatCast powered by Amazon Web Services is going to talk about the hustle for Rivera for their run. He beat out a double play, max speed just under 20, and he got out of the box knowing exactly what he had to do. Never looked to see the ball, put his head down and ran through the bag. And that's where we stand right now, 1-0 Puerto Rico.
Little cue shot off the end of the bat. Perez has to get there to cover, and the throw goes bad. That's going to score a second Puerto Rico run.
Well, right on cue, he's now the architect behind two of the runs. In between play, that just relies on the communication of the first baseman getting the ball to the pitcher in stride. This is one of the most difficult plays to try it all in spring training. You got to read it. And he took kind of a tough route, did Perez. You're supposed to take a straight line between the mound and home, and the mound and first base, and he took more of a towards second base before he came to first base.
Scored as a single and an error charge to Perez. And that's going to be all for the Venezuela starter here this afternoon. Our first pitching change comes with a run in and two away in the third. We'll be right back. Hey, JP.
Yeah, what's up, guys?
Can you confirm that Ben Como signed with the Marlins?
I will work on that right now.
Thanks, man.
StatCast powered by Amazon Web Services is going to tell us again, getting out of the box. And again at 19.9. Rivera seeing his opportunity to get to the back before the pitcher. And
resulted in another Puerto Rican runner. So two times getting to first base has helped the Puerto Rican team have a 2-0 lead.
Mike Aviles, with two away, a run in and a runner aboard, will be the first to face the new pitcher on the mound for Venezuela. Right-hander Omar Bencomo.
All on.
Fastball, three-quarter delivery. Ball cuts and sinks. Slider has a smaller break. And one of the downfalls for the Venezuelan team has been their bullpen.
Yeah, 26 and two-third innings by the Venezuela pen in this tournament. They've allowed 29 runs on 10 home runs. In part. Bullpen ERA well over 9. Rivera advances on the pass ball. Omar Bencomo just signed. He inked a minor league deal with the Marlins just recently. He's kicked around in the minor leagues with Tampa Bay, with Minnesota. Two balls and no strikes. Rivera in scoring position now. That Japan was in the Cactus League, and that one's underway.
It is underway, Matt, and don't let anyone tell you I haven't done my homework this winter on the WBC. I was selling you on Ryosuke Kikuchi. My friend, he has homered off John Lackey just a short time ago.
Look at you. By the way, no one has ever accused you of that. You're quite the opposite, sir.
I love it.
There are some people, JP, that are actually worried about your state of mind when this event ends. They don't know what will happen with you.
I'm one of those people, Matt. I am. I'm giving it some thought. I'll have to reacquaint myself with Major League Baseball. You know, the 15 teams in the AL and the NL?
Yes.
That's my assignment. I'll have about a week in between. Again, refamiliarize myself with who signed where, who was traded where. But for right now, it's all about the Dutch, Team Japan, and, of course, the teams here today.
Got it. And whoever wins tonight. Moving on to LA, the U.S. and the Dominican Republic, 7 local time, 10 o'clock in the East. Danny Duffy and Irvin Santana. Whoever wins advances. A ball and one strike to count to Rene Rivera. To left. Run down by Solarte. Puerto Rico does push across another run, and at the end of 2.5, they lead it 2-0. Venezuela is a nation of over 31 million people. Capital and largest city is Caracas. Biggest oil reserves in the world, approximately 300 billion barrels if you're counting. And it's the home to Angel Falls, among the many picturesque spots in Venezuela. Highest waterfall in the world.
You ever been?
I have not. Have you?
No.
I've been to South America.
All on.
Anywhere down there for you?
I've been to Puerto Rico, but that's South America.
Yeah.
That's as far as I've gone.
Okay. Here's Robin Chicharinos to lead things off in the Venezuela half of the third. Number 9 hitter, then the top
right.
Ciarte and Altuve. There are many distinguished Venezuelans in uniform here today, JP.
Well, Matt, we love working with the mayor Sean Casey at MLB Network. But Venezuela has an actual sitting mayor on its support staff, Maglio Ordonez, the sitting mayor of the city of Puerto La Cruz. He's actually up for re-election, Maddie, in the month of December. He told me undecided if he's going to run again. When I asked him how the job was going, he says, it's actually pretty hard.
I think most people that get into politics later in life find it to be that way. The ball and two strikes, the count to Robinson Chirinos. Maglio Ordonez has had such a good career. Big hits with the Tigers, big hits in Chicago, his time there. Wave and a miss by Chirinos.
De Leon wiggled his way out of trouble and throwing the ball pretty good for Team Puerto Rico.
Top of the order now, back to Ender and Ciarte. Ciarte hooks a ball into the right field corner. He's on his way to second with a one out double.
Ciarte and the Braves hoping that that offense of the second half continues for them as they, hard to believe, go into a new stadium.
Yeah, what's all the talk down there? You're down there in that world.
It's going to be interesting because, you know, typically when teams build a new stadium, you look for the timing for that to be right into a competitive campaign and possibly playoffs. But I think the mindset of the Braves is they've rebuilt their farm system or trying, and maybe next year they'll be competitive this year.
Jose Altuve now.
They signed a couple veteran guys to fill the rotation spots while some young players are developing. What do you know there? See that shirt? Can't believe that.
Still
here.
Making those, huh?
What's going on?
Oh, and one the count to Jose Altuve. Well, Ender and Ciarte came in the Dansby Swanson deal, and that's the one that's getting the big time thumbs up from Atlanta. Shelby Miller sent to Arizona. Dansby Swanson and Ender and Ciarte to the Braves. And Ciarte won a gold glove last year. Dansby Swanson is that kind of key building piece, former number one overall pick. And there's still a chance that Shelby Miller can turn it around and replicate his 2015 season. But last year seemed to be a step back for him. So far you score that trade as a win for the Braves. And there have been a couple like that.
Yeah, they're still waiting on a couple young pitchers to get to the next level. Foltynewicz looks like he's a mainstay in the rotation now.
Two and two to Altuve. What are they saying about the ballpark? Is it going to be true? Is it going to have a pitching flavor to it?
I think it's changed. I think it originally was, I heard some complaints out of hitters when it was the dimensions were going up. It's going to be a smaller park in attendance. I think it's going to be more of a hitter's ballpark. So much construction going up around that area.
And a called strike three taken by Altuve.
Uncharacteristic for Altuve. We've seen some strikeouts already. Two on the night today, and he's had a few in the tournament.
That's going to be all for De Leon. He's already going through the congratulatory handshakes on his way out. Threw the ball well today. Puerto Rico goes to its bullpen in the third inning, and we'll be right back. Welcome back to this World Baseball Classic telecast on MLB Network, presented by GEICO. With John Smoltz and J.P. Morosi, Matt Vasgersian, and a 2-0 lead for Puerto Rico, having already qualified to advance to the semifinals. Puerto Rico tuning up in their last game here in San Diego. Roberto Perez leads things off in the Puerto Rico half of inning number 4. Perez, Fuentes, and Pagan. The U.S. and the Dominican Republic tonight at 7 o'clock local time, 10 o'clock east. Back with you for that one to determine final semifinalist, the last of the four teams which will move on. Whoever wins tonight advances. The loser is done for the tournament.
And Como's got his slider working.
Omar Bencomo came on to finish off the last inning. Base on balls, and then a fly ball got him out of any further trouble. And after Puerto Rico scored a run on the error. Chopper to third. Altuve's got it. Between innings, J.P. Morosi visited with Venezuela's manager Omar Vizquel.
Omar, for someone who wants to manage in the big leagues, what are the most important things you've taken from this experience?
I think the communication with your players, it has been pretty good. You know, I've been able to send a message to each and one of them, and the response has been great. Things hasn't been going our way, but I think everybody's happy with the role they have, and, you know, hopefully I can take that home with me.
Victor Martinez, probably representing Venezuela for the final time here this afternoon. What has he meant to baseball in Venezuela?
It means a lot. Victor is one of those hitters that sometimes he goes unnoticed because he always been hitting behind a lot of hitters like Miguel Cabrera and Magly Ordóñez and other hitters. But he's had a great career. He represents power for us. He represents leadership. And he's also a great guy. So you can't find a better guy than Victor Martinez in this game. So I wish him luck. He's still with Detroit, and I get to enjoy him another 2 years.
Omar, gracias.
Omar will return to Tigers camp when this is all said and done to resume his duties as the first base coach for Brad Auspice. Hey, a fine play on the right side of the infield there on a tough chance.
Wow, that really was a nice play. When you don't spend a lot of time with each other, you rely on the mechanics of that play being exactly what it is. Pitcher get over. Get rid of it as quickly as you can. He gave it to him in timing and in stride.
The versatility of Hernan Perez. He looked like an everyday first baseman on that chance.
Great shot right there. Coming into your living room.
Two-gone bases empty now for Angel Pagan. Bencomo trying for what could be Venezuela's first 1-2-3 inning against Puerto Rico today. Oh, and two. Has doubled, scored, and lined to right tonight. He's hit the ball hard in both of his at-bats this afternoon. That one sprayed the other way. And caught by Solarte for a 1-2-3 inning. Middle of the fourth this afternoon in San Diego, our first of two. Puerto Rico continues to lead as we send you back to the MLB Network studios for this Geico Studio Update. More spring training games coming your way on MLB Network tomorrow. Twins and Red Sox at 1 Eastern, then in primetime, Royals and Cubs at 10. Spring training baseball on MLB Network presented by Best Western. Cubs taking on the Japanese team today, as J.P. Morosi reported earlier this afternoon. Victor Martinez leads things off in Venezuela's half of the fourth.
Tony Gwynn.
One of the all-time greats. Forever Mr. Padre here. We were talking to Jim Leland earlier in the tournament, the manager of Team USA, about his memories of managing here in this city. Most of those came at the old ballpark, old Jack Murphy Stadium, then Qualcomm. Now just an empty place. And his memories of managing as a Rockies manager, as a Marlins manager here in the city, consisted of trying to get Tony Gwynn out. Something he thought was a futile exercise. Until finally instructing his pitching coaches and staffs, hey, just throw it down the middle. Hope he pulls the ball right to somebody. Because if you work the corners, he's going to go that way.
That's exactly right. I found that out too late. He absolutely owned me.
Hall of Fame career, and Tony Gwynn, another multi-sport star, played basketball here at SDSU. That's his 3,000th hit that you saw there up in Montreal. 3,141 altogether. And a first ballot inductee back in 2007, and gone far too soon.
No doubt he could have hit 40 home runs if he wanted to, but he would have sacrificed some average.
Really one of the pioneers in using video, the way it's been so standardized in baseball these days, as a hitting tool. Ground ball chance at third, and Martinez is retired on another good play by Correa. Between innings, J.P. Morosi visited with Puerto Rico's manager Edwin Rodriguez.
Well, Edwin, with the way De Leon pitched today, a short start, an effective one, is he an option for you now in L.A.?
Yeah. He was a very good outing for him. He did what we were expecting him to do. He was up. His max pitch count was 50 pitches. So he did good, and he kept us in the game. As a matter of fact, we were ahead. So he was a very good outing. I'm very happy for him.
For Monday, Edwin, what are you thinking about in terms of potentially Lopez or Berríos?
For now, we are more inclined to start Jorge Lopez with Santiago and Berríos behind him. So for now, it will be Jorge Lopez on Monday.
See you in L.A.
See you there.
Certainly not too soon to start making those decisions, as Carlos Gonzalez digs in now with one gone. Should the U.S. qualify, and again, that's all pending the game with the Dominican Republic tonight, Jim Leland has already identified Tanner Roark as his starter in the semifinals in Los Angeles. A ball and two strikes to Carlos Gonzalez.
Pitch there, right down underneath the sweet spot of Cargo with the big long swing. Likes it out over the plate. This just gets underneath the sweet zone.
Two and two. The Kingdom of the Netherlands, as J.P. reported earlier, is also in action in the Cactus League today, and they're trailing Zach Greinke and the Diamondbacks 5-0 in the third.
What do you think about that? I think the Diamondbacks are going to have a good year this year. I think it's a bounce back.
Yeah.
I do. I think everything that could go bad last year did. And their pitching staff's going to be much better. Greinke's going to be better. You talked about Shelby Miller. They made a trade for Taijuan Walker.
Yeah, I'd have a hard time thinking that they're going to struggle the way they did last year. Hey. Bullpen straightened out. And a called strike three as Gonzalez is straightened up. A healthy full season of A.J. Pollock is a great start. Yasmani Tomas has established himself as one of the better run producers in the division. You know what you got with guys like Goldschmidt. New switch hitter in the lineup, Ketel Marte, who came with Taijuan Walker. That's the key guy for me. If Taijuan Walker is what they want him to be, they're going to be pretty good. Here's Alcides Escobar now with two away. It's been everybody chasing the Dodgers and Giants in the NL West for the last few years. And I would imagine it's going to be a similar story this year. I think the Rockies will be a lot better. The Ian Desmond injury is troubling, but that's a loaded lineup. That's the Vanguard brand, that of the Dodgers in the NL West. Smash to third. Picked up by Correa to make for a 1-2-3-4. Rolling right along this afternoon in the middle of the day. Nice afternoon for Fido. 2-0 Puerto Rico.
Get up for something good this season with MLB Central. Join Matt Mascursion with Mark DeRosa and Lauren Shahadi and special guests for your leadoff look at the day in baseball, plus all the news that's central to the game. MLB Central presented by Hyundai. Returning Monday. That's Monday, April 3rd on MLB Network.
Back to work in the top of the fifth. A 2-0 lead for Puerto Rico as they send up Kike Hernandez to lead things off. Hernandez, Correa, and Vargas. Puerto Rico already aware of their fate. They're heading on to Los Angeles for the semifinals next week. That young talent is still unsigned. Hey, throw a strike, why don't you? Something to hit. See the top hand release there?
Very nice.
Two balls and a strike to count to Kike Hernandez. There's a ball well hit to left. Solarte gathers it in at the wall. Omar Bencomo has retired all but one of the hitters he's faced since coming out of the third. He lost Mike Avilas on the leadoff walk, but has since retired five in a row. And now he's got Carlos Correa to deal with the bases empty and one gone.
Carlos Correa swinging it a little bit better now.
He has doubled and walked tonight. Tonight, it's today.
It's tonight somewhere, man.
You know what I'm doing? I'm getting ready for the big one tonight. That's what I'm doing. I'm warming up for the U.S. and the DR. You know, the fact that these double headers are separated by a pretty healthy gap of time is very much a good thing. Whoever set the schedule knew what they were doing, because the last time we did a doubleheader last weekend in Miami, the Dominican Republic and Colombia went into extra innings. It's a long game, 4 hours, 11 innings, and had it not been for that time between innings, or between games rather, would have made something not work. It's Correa's aboard on a walk.
I think it was 4:42 was our time of game.
Was it just missed being the longest WBC game ever? But remember, as soon as the game was over, we stretched our legs and walked downstairs to get lineups and such, and the two teams who were playing in the nightcaps couldn't get into the clubhouses yet. So the Canadian team was, they were eating sandwiches kind of standing around the lobby in their street clothes, some in their uniforms. Kenny's Vargas has struck out twice today. One out, one on for him here in the fifth. So I would imagine that Team USA and Team Dominican Republic are still very much in repose at the hotel. Game's over 5 hours away. There's no place for them to go. Maybe they're on their way here shortly to sit in the stands. What do you think?
I think they get on the bus around 3:30. 3:30, head down.
Okay.
Anticipate the transition.
Stand about a half an hour or so away at Torrey Pines. A ball and a strike to Kenny's Vargas. Balls and a strike to Kenny's Vargas.
Does have a little James Shields type stretch working where he peeks over.
He's got a James Shields like pace going too. Three and one. TJ Rivera waits on deck. And two strikes to Kenny's Vargas.
Vargas swinging and missing a lot already. Just trying to get again the timing and feel. Aggressive on that 3-1 pitch. See if we can get a little exit velocity here on this pitch off the bat of Vargas.
And he's caught looking this time. Third time he struck out this afternoon. It's a rough hat trick. Hasn't played at all in San Diego in his first game. Three strikeouts start his day.
You're not going to be happy when he looks back at the film and see two of them.
So still a runner aboard with two away now, and it's going to be up to TJ Rivera. He's reached on a fielder's choice and an error today. Rivera with a base hit on board again. This guy's played himself right into the plans. You know, last year when he came up from AAA Las Vegas to play for the Mets down the stretch, it was out of necessity. There were some injured middle infielders there. Wilmer Flores was banged up. Despite the fact that he hit 350 in the Coast League, folks thought of him kind of as a temporary stopgap player until everybody could get healthy. Neil Walker was hurt. He ended up starting at second base in the wild card game for the Mets last year. He's played himself right into the plans. JP, those guys are healthy this year, though. There's going to be a little bit of a playing time battle at that spot in New York.
There will be, Matt, but again, TJ Rivera, amazing story. Lehman High School in the Bronx. He was an undrafted free agent from Troy University in Alabama.
A ball and no strikes, the count to Mike Aviles. Another Bronx guy at the plate. And a strike to Aviles, it's 1-1. Aviles lines a breaking ball to left. Puerto Rico.
Correa getting a good jump. Aviles picking on a breaking ball. And he makes the turn real easy. Powerful runner. On top that he could show off.
Bill Robinson Chirinos goes to chat with Bencomo. Two out trouble for the Venezuela right-hander here. He had Correa aboard with two gone, lost Rivera to the base hit, and then the RBI single by Aviles, and now Rene Rivera has a chance. Rene Rivera with a double on his line today. Runners at second and third, a run in for him with two gone.
On one.
Ball and a strike to Rivera. Again, the U.S. and Dominican Republic still to come tonight. The nightcap. And whereas this game is meaningless in terms of the standings in the pool because Puerto Rico's already qualified to move on, tonight means everything. The U.S. gets its shot at a rematch tonight with everything on the line. We're talking about what the teams are doing as they prepare tonight, JP, the fact that they're not here at the ballpark yet. Have you talked to anybody with Team USA?
Yes, confirmed to me, Maddie, right now they are preparing to leave. The bus leaves the hotel at 3 o'clock. No off-site BP, so again, cages at the very worst for them. So presumably, Matt, they're watching us right now.
Next pitch for Combo. Rivera rolls over a ground ball to third for Altuve to minimize the damage at a single run. We've reached the midway point this afternoon. Puerto Rico's moving on. And they've got a 3-0 lead in the sun and surf splendor of San Diego. This World Baseball Classic telecast on MLB Network is brought to you by the Puerto Rico Tourism Company. Visit seepuertorico.com to plan your trip today. And by Lexus, experience the thrill of the Lexus Command Performance Sales Event now through March 31st. See your Lexus dealer. And by the DQ $5 lunch, now served all day, every day. Back with John Smoltz and J.P. Morosi, Matt Vasgersian in San Diego, a 3-0 lead for Team Puerto Rico as Yanhervis Solarte leads things off in the Venezuela half of inning number five. Solarte, Perez, and Chirinos, bottom third of Omar Vizquel's order.
All he's done is hit three out of four here in San Diego.
Talked a little bit about Solarte earlier in the tournament, some of the personal adversity he's gone through, dealing with the tragic loss of his wife to cancer. His courageous return to the Padres after that tragedy. And from a purely baseball standpoint, maybe one of the lesser known commodities in the NL West. A lot of ex-Yankee teammates spoke glowingly about him. A lot of his teammates in San Diego, Matt Kemp, before he was traded away from here, said he's probably the best player on our team that nobody knows about. Still a ball and two strikes. I think more people are becoming aware that Yanhervis Solarte is a good player, JP. He's no longer the secret he may have been a couple of seasons ago.
You are absolutely right, Matty. And in fact, the Padres have signed him to a two-year, $7.5 million extension with team options for 2019 and 2020. So clearly they see the value there with Solarte.
A guy that can play all over the place, hit for occasional power. Ball and two strikes to him. Soto's next pitch is fouled away. Giovanni Soto came on for Jose De Leon in the third. He has retired all four batters that he's faced. Grounds that one fair up the line as Correa gets him for out number one.
Clubs in 30 days, almost done.
Yeah, where do we see Brian Kenny and Kevin Millar today?
Twins.
Twins.
Right. That's right.
Here's Hernan Perez now. Robinson Chirinos on deck for Venezuela. Perez with a drive out to left. Ball really launched, but caught at the wall by Angel Pagan. Sure sounded like he got it. Sure looked off the bat as though he had it. Missed it by that much.
Yeah, well, wind is blowing. It's blowing in. This ball got way up there. It looked like right at the end it was fading back. And the sound after that ball was hit, I'm sure Soto thought, oh shoot. But pleasantly surprised.
Here's Robinson Chirinos now with two away. Six in a row retired by Soto since coming on out of the bullpen.
We had a no hitter the other day, right? In spring training. I think the Tigers got no hit by the Yankees.
I didn't see that.
Yeah.
Been locked into WBC land here for so long. I wonder if JP took a breath from this event to notice that. If not, I'll feel a little better.
Doubtful. It escaped my notice, Matt.
Okay.
As you would expect.
The spring training.
This is full immersion, my friend.
Yeah.
Full immersion.
The spring training no hitter. Still rare.
Yeah.
How many pitchers?
Three pitchers. I think Tanaka started that game. I mean, the Tigers are missing quite a few players.
Yeah. Well,
roster,
right? They're all here, or at least a lot of them. kind of forgotten about Masahiro Tanaka, haven't we?
Yeah, everyone anticipated since the news a few years ago of his injury, which was going to definitely be a Tommy John scenario. He hasn't had it, and he's been pretty darn good, kind of under the radar.
Yeah, really has. He's a WBC alum, pitched in this event twice for Team Japan. Most of his work coming out of the bullpen.
How do you say, is it Makita for Japan, the closer, throw sidearm, or one of the relievers?
Yes.
Man, do I like watching him pitch.
Another high fly ball. This one not nearly as deep. In fact, it's cracked at shortstop by Hernandez. That's a catch. We're okay. A 1-2-3 inning for Giovanni Soto. I got it. 3-0 Puerto Rico. Follow every pitch of this year's World Baseball Classic live with the MLB.com At-Bat mobile app, your number one app for live baseball. Join Major League Baseball in new era as we celebrate opening day. Wear your cap April 3rd and send a photo. Share it on social media using hashtag CapsOn. And watch all the opening day action April 3rd on ESPN, MLB Network, and MLB.com. Well, from Torrey Pines south to Petco Park, where Puerto Rico continues to lead 3-0 here in the top half of the sixth inning. Roberto Perez leads it off. Perez, Fuentes, and Pagan. Among the most surprising developments in the San Diego bracket, the fact that one John Smoltz has not played a single hole of golf.
Committed. In no time.
Lined into right for a base hit. Floored by that.
Yeah, I walk into the hotel room and the clubs are sitting there, and as if they could talk, they're like, are you kidding me? We haven't left this weather. It's beautiful outside. Torrey Pines right down the road.
Might I remind you, sir, there is no gambling at Bushwood, and I never slice.
Never played there.
Really?
No. Played a lot of golf here, though, in San Diego. This was an unbelievable spot. This was guaranteed golf when he showed up here. Of course, most of our starters, when they weren't pitching, was making up the foursome.
Here's Raymond Fuentes now. Did you guys ever drag a position player out there with you?
Yeah.
Yeah,
when a catcher wouldn't play, it was Greg Olson, or every once in a while, you know, we get some days off. Adam LaRoche. Chipper Jones would play every once in a while.
Strike to Fuentes, who's hitless today. He struck out in the second, grounded to the right side in the fourth. Still to come tonight, the U.S. and the Dominican Republic. That's the big one. The winner in that game moves on to the semifinals in L.A., and the loser's 2017 tournament comes to an end. J.P. Morosi reported on this when we were in Miami, that a lot of the U.S. players, after having a six-inning lead over the Dominican Republic in Miami last week, one that would go away and fall to an eventual loss, they were already looking forward to this return engagement with the DR in a more hospitable circumstance. That game was played on U.S. soil last week, and the American team was the decided visitor. I would say it was 90% Dominican Republic at Marlins Park that day. It's going to be different here today. I think the U.S. crowd is going to come out and be a little bit more vocal.
Especially what's at stake now. The loser going home and the winner moving on.
Danny Duffy for Team USA, Irvin Santana for the Dominicans. Great matchup tonight. Santana will be making his 2017 World Baseball Classic debut. Two balls and two strikes.
Was hit pretty good. You see that down and in we talked about. Ciarte almost. He can, if anyone can track it down, he can. And once it gets there, it's an easy double and an easy run score.
Fourth double of the day for Puerto Rico. They've played it a run in four of the six innings that they've opened today. And it's back to the top of the order in Angel Pagan. Strokes a base hit into right. And away Fuentes around to score. 5-0 Puerto Rico. Omar Bencomo held up nicely through his first inning in the third, gave up the run in the fifth, and two here in the sixth without recording an out. Kiki Hernandez is the batter. Watching the tournament, you've certainly noticed by now not only all the blonde locks, but the fact that every time a Puerto Rico player cashes in with an RBI or an extra base hit, the helmet comes off and they're rubbing each other's hair a lot. I got one of the t-shirts yesterday, Smoltz.
I heard that. Yeah. Somebody came up and
forgot to bring it with me, though. There's even a nickname for this this movement, this new fashion movement on Team Puerto Rico, JP.
Well, Matt, we have some great social media teammates on Twitter, the at MLB Network, at MLB, and at Cut 4 Twitter accounts. And it was the Cut 4 Twitter account that we could credit with this beauty. The Bleach Boys.
Yes.
The Bleach Boys.
Very good.
Love it. Love it.
Well played. Ground ball to third. And Venezuela's able to turn two. Even the old veteran getting into the act. Yes, the Bleach Boys coming to a Los Angeles venue soon. Why not? I think it's exactly what Brian Wilson had in mind when he wrote that song in the 60s. Someday they'll use this on Team Puerto Rico at the World Baseball Classic. Carlos Correa now with the bases empty after the double play ball. Two runs in with two away now in the sixth inning. 5-0 ball game. By the way, I wanted to get your temperature on that out there that we just saw. That the little beach that they have here in right center field.
Yeah.
No longer do they display the retired numbers of San Diego Padres players on the batter's eye as they once did. They're now on surfboards out there.
I like it.
Yeah, so do I. Trevor Hoffman, Randy Jones, Dave Winfield, Tony Gwynn, Steve Garvey. You know what I've never been able to get confirmation on all these years is that if Steve Garvey's number was actually retired or not. When this team moved in here from the old ballpark, there used to be a number 6 on the wall where Steve Garvey hit that memorable postseason home run to sink the Cubs in 1984, one of the biggest swings in franchise history. So a couple years later, or I think it was the following year, they put a number 6 on the wall on the spot where the ball went out. So the assumption was for many years that the number was retired. They moved here and added it to the numbers that were retired, Randy Jones, Dave Winfield, etc. But I don't know that anybody's ever confirmed that it was formally retired. I don't think it's been an issue. It's not like a guy's been traded here and said, I demand number 6 or I walk.
Well, we know. We know who will get us the answer.
Just got it. Keith Costas just told us that the last guy to wear number 6 here was Keith Moreland in 1988. And a called strike 3 taken by Carlos Correa. Could have been worse, but 2 more for Team Puerto Rico. A team that is having a lot of fun in San Diego. You see them wearing their baggies, Huarache sandals too. A bushy, bushy blonde hairdo, serving USA. There's a new season coming, and MLB Network is bringing you 11 live opening week games, plus live look-ins and analysis from the best of the biz on MLB Tonight. Opening week coverage presented by Best Western, beginning April 2nd on MLB Network. Ender Inciarte leads off the home half of inning number 6. Venezuela in a 5-0 hole, back with John Smoltz and J.P. Morosi, Matt Vasgersian, working our way through this opener in our day-night doubleheader as Hiram Burgos takes over on the mound. And again, the nightcap still to come. The U.S. and the Dominican Republic. The winner moves on to the tournament. Line right first as Rivera's got it for route number 1.
He's got a good live arm action. Fastball's not overpowering. He's got some sink to it. Good curveball, good changeup. Getting some work in.
One away for Jose Altuve.
All one.
Curveball stays outside. 1-0. Burgos is a returnee to World Baseball Classic play. He was in the event in 2013. Gave up only 1 earned run in 13 innings of work. Sixth-round draft selection by the Brewers in 2012. He's made only 6 starts in his major league career as Jose Altuve gets to him for a base hit. Not sure. Carlos Correa may have lost that in the shadow for a moment.
That it gets to him a lot quicker over there than it does in short. Ball was tattooed.
There's Rougned Odor now after the 1-out single.
Odor in Mexico probably has the longest recorded single.
Yes.
Thought he hit a walk off or a go ahead. Stay in the ballpark.
Into center field and well hit. and gone. Third of the tournament for Rougned Odor, and it gets Venezuela on the board in the sixth.
Right on cue, this one he kept running because this is a little different than Mexico. This ballpark has not yielded a ton of them, but that ball just gets over the wall. Another classic Odor big swing and big results.
To the shift goes Victor Martinez for route number two.
Shorter wall, but he didn't quite get back there in time. I don't know that he'd been able to get up and keep that one from going out.
So a two gone now, it's Carlos Gonzalez for a third time. He has singled and struck out.
Ball one.
Puerto Rico overloads the right side. Right to the shift to retire the side. Not before Rougned Odor can add a little offense to Venezuela's afternoon. His third home run of the tournament makes it a three-run game. Some changes for Team Venezuela as we start things in the top half of inning number seven. Jesus Flores takes over behind the plate. The former national will catch the remainder of this one. And Will Ledesma is the new pitcher for Venezuela. He'll face Kenny Vargas to start things out. Vargas, Rivera, and Aviles for Puerto Rico.
Ledesma, slider, late break, tight break to it. Fastball has some sink. Some numbers in the Mexican League.
Pitched in this ballpark, one of his major league employers, the San Diego Padres, time with the Braves, the Diamondbacks, the Nationals. Most recent affiliation was with the Dodgers in 2012 when he spent the season at AAA for them. A guy that's been around, 36-year-old veteran left-hander. Talked about so many unsigned players being here represented on the Puerto Rico side. JP, any chance a guy like Will Ledesma uses this to get another major league contract?
Very possible, Matt. In fact, there are a number of major league scouts here today. I saw them up in the press box earlier today. Ledesma told me a short time ago before the game began his family's here with him. He's looking to sign somewhere. Mexico is one option, but he'd like to try to get back into organized ball. One note on him, Matt, he was the winning pitcher, talking about Maglio Ordonez in the famous walk-off to clinch the ALCS back in 2006. Ledesma was the winning pitcher for the Tigers that night.
I did not recall that. Nice. Very nice note. Is that Sal Butera that we just saw there?
Yes, I believe so. Saw him in the yellow.
Longtime big league catcher who has been a scout for probably longer than his playing career by this time. He's a member of the Italian coaching staff, a team that was eliminated in the Jalisco bracket. Three-two to Vargas.
No.
And Vargas is aboard. He adds a walk to his three-strikeout afternoon. So the fourth plate appearance of the day for T.J. Rivera, and he's been on base in all three of his previous appearances, a fielder's choice, an error, and a base hit.
Don't think the error was justified, by the way. I think it should have been a base hit.
They actually went back and changed that scoring decision. It was initially scored as a base hit and an error on the pitcher. That was the ball that was kind of fumbled at first base between Martin Perez and Hernan Perez. Rivera to left. And off the wall. Woo. Second and third to start the seventh.
Rivera's having a day. That time he used his bat a little more effectively. The first two times it was his legs. Catcher sets up in. Ball does not quite get there. Barrel of the bat beats the ball. Over the head of the outfielder for an easy double.
Here's Mike Aviles now. Five doubles for Puerto Rico this afternoon. Aviles has walked and singled in a run today. Puerto Rico is going to be a tough out.
They are. Their offense seems to be pretty connected. Scored a lot of runs over in Mexico. They've scored enough runs here and certainly came out last night with six straight hits. And Yachty has led this very underrated pitching staff. I'll be honest, I just, when we knew we were doing this, and you know about the roster of the U.S., you know about the roster of Dominican Republic, you knew about some of the offensive stars, young stars that Puerto Rico had, maybe not enough paying attention to what their pitching staff has been
able
to do.
Yeah, I would agree. Edwin Diaz has been really impressive as Aviles lines another base hit to left. Vargas scores, Rivera right behind it. And Puerto Rico gets their five-run lead back in a hurry. Had a nice tournament. Hasn't played a whole lot here this year. Three RBIs for him today. Mike Aviles was actually the RBI leader for Team Puerto Rico in the last running of the tournament back in 2013. This team would like nothing more than to have another shot at winning the whole thing. Lost in the championship round last running to the Dominican Republic in San Francisco. That'll bring up Rene Rivera. JP.
batting. Now, listen, when you look at this team, for me, for Puerto Rico, John used a great word, connected. The at-bats are connected because the lineup has basically been the same.
That's into left center field as Rene Rivera connects. Avilas is being waved around. He'll score without a play at the plate. RBI double, 3 runs in the inning. To 2 Puerto Rico. And Omar Vizquel coming out. He's seen enough. He wants a pitching change. So not the outing that Will Ledesma was hoping for. A walk and then 3 straight hits. An 8-2 lead for Puerto Rico as they look to add on a pitching change, and we'll be right back.
Well, earlier in the game, this play, the very difficult between the pitcher and the first baseman. Well, it didn't get done there. And Rivera was able to beat it out. It's one of those plays you got to read as a first baseman. Well, I had one of these plays right here in this ballpark. Didn't quite turn out as well as I thought. I got it, I'm telling them. And at this point, I thought that I was tagging the bag right there, only to come up a few feet short. That was a tight ball game, by the way, and I felt like making the play at first was essential. 2-1 game. So anyways, the intent was there. The desire was certainly there. The results were not.
Now, you were closing in those days.
No, right? I was starting.
That was your game to start? Okay.
I was starting, yeah.
And did you guys end up winning that game?
I think we did. I'm not sure if that win got blown or not. You know, I had the lead when I left.
Okay. Pitching change brings John Daniel Medina onto the game. He'll face Roberto Perez with 3 runs into the inning and nobody out. Perez sends a drive out to center field. And Ciarte's got it. That advances Rivera to third with 1 away. I would imagine that that did not go without the notice of your teammates.
Well, you know how teammates are, right? They're certainly, they're very compassionate. So on the flight home, they had a video that played throughout the flight of the fire department, drop, stop, and roll. They said they were going to use that for any kind of, you know, in case there was a fire. Yeah, I got worn out. You know, they called me the fryer when my hat came off. You saw the back of my head. There was a lot of opportunities to.
Did you take a divot? I mean, it looked like the ground screw needed to do a little.
In all honesty, I ended up, you know, in the heat of the moment, you think you're making a play. I ended up hurting my ribs pretty bad. I take that fall right there, and the last one, I ended up having to have a cortisone shot for my next start, which I believe was in Boston. But yeah, that's 6'3", 230 tumbling around, not very pretty.
Love
right
the
here.
Love the effort, though. Raymond Fuentes, a batter with 1 away and a runner at third. By the way, I understand you guys lost that game in extra innings.
So the game did get blown.
Two balls and a strike.
It's either Cirillo or Loretta diving into first base. The unfortunate thing for him is he ended up dislocating and tearing ligaments in his thumb sliding into first base.
That was Mark Loretta, who is still aboard here as a consultant, as a matter of fact. 3 balls and a strike to count to Raymond Fuentes.
Had a lot happen here in San Diego. This was the place after my first win in Shea Stadium. Came out west. Of course, I was as happy as you can imagine winning your first game. And I got a note on my chair. It says, Mr. Bear would like to do an interview with you. So, of course, I got right to the payphone or right to the phone in the clubhouse. I got the number. I called it up. Didn't understand why all my teammates were coming around the phone. And it was the San Diego Zoo.
quickly realized that the big leagues were no different than anything else. They were going to win.
Angel Pagan, the batter now, with runners at first and third after the base on balls. Ball and no strikes, the count to Angel Pagan. Seventh Puerto Rico hitter to come to the plate this inning. Pagan's had a good afternoon. 2 for 4, he scored a run. 8 runs on 12 hits, and this one's starting to look a lot like the first time Puerto Rico played Venezuela in Jalisco last week, when the early termination rule was put into effect in an 11-0 game. There's another RBI knock. I wouldn't be surprised if Angel Pagan is signed tonight.
Well, him and Avilas are doing their best efforts here in this tournament. That's a good job on a high fastball, getting on top.
It's a matter of staying healthy, and Angel has told a lot of folks how good he feels right now. Here's Kike Hernandez. No denying the impact he had on the Giants during his 4 years there. 2014 was the year that a lot was made of these numbers, with and without Angel Pagan. Quite a difference. Much better than a 500 team with him, and much worse than a 500 team without him. Almost a run per game difference when he was in the lineup. Just a refresher on the early termination rules. A 10 or more run lead after 7 innings means the game is over. Of course, you'd have to complete the bottom of the inning for that to kick in. And it's still just a 7-run ball game. And Hernandez takes ball 4. This copyrighted telecast is presented by Authority, the World Baseball Classic, Inc., and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form. And the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without express written consent.
Well, another trip to Team Venezuela. That has been a common theme, really, the last 3 games. A lot of conversations, a lot of developing, a lot of trying to prepare some of these young players for future opportunities in the big leagues. Medina in the minors with the Cubs. Fastball slider guy.
Well, the 2015 American League Rookie of the Year, Carlos Correa, has an opportunity to move Puerto Rico even closer to their trip up the road to LA. He's walked twice, scored a couple of runs, and doubled. The 9th Puerto Rico batter to hit this inning.
Ball one.
This young man get his arms extended, really strong gap to gap. I think he's a 40 home run guy. especially in the ballpark he plays in.
Fly ball in a shallow right. Carlos Gonzalez makes the catch. Hunter tags, throw to the plate. He is not in time. Throw down to third is in time there. Fuentes scores. Pagan throw down to third. All told, a 5-run inning for Team Puerto Rico. Welcome back to this World Baseball Classic telecast on MLB Network, presented by Geico. A commanding lead for the team headed north to Los Angeles for the semifinals next week. Puerto Rico opening up a 10-2 advantage with a 5-run top half of the seventh. And Alcides Escobar will lead off for Venezuela in the bottom of the inning. Still to come tonight, of course, the U.S. and the Dominican Republic for the right to join Puerto Rico and move on. One gone to start the last of the seventh.
That ball was going foul. And that wind up there held it up. Brought it back to Pagan.
Danny Duffy for Team USA, Irvin Santana for the Dominicans. And again, that's for the chance to stay alive in the tournament. The loser breaks up and redistributes its roster to big league camps. Here's Yanervis Solarte now. Kind of curious to see what the United States lineup is going to be, and I know that Jim Leland he's been up at night playing with the various combinations for each of these games, and he has a lot to choose from, a lot to work with today, JP, as always.
He does, Matt, and as our Keith Costas looked up earlier today, a lot of players on this team that have experience in winner-take-all games, a Game 7 of a World Series or LCS, Game 5 of a Division Series, and Buster Posey is one of those names. Now, Matt, we would expect Lucroy to catch tonight because that's been Leland's routine every other day, but you do wonder, Matt, could Posey be the DH?
Oh, that's an intriguing thought, because the U.S. really hasn't gotten a lot of productivity out of the DH spot so far. Paul Goldschmidt hasn't really heated up yet. Giancarlo Stanton really hasn't heated up yet. I'm curious to see who he leads off with, because I think Ian Kinsler is going to be back in there, so it would likely be him. Led off yesterday with Andrew McCutchen before he was ejected. Didn't even have a chance to finish 9 innings.
Well, this becomes the tough part, because you're not going to give somebody the opportunity to work out of trouble too much from a pitching standpoint. Your pitchers are going to have to be on point. And your tendency is to go with guys that are swinging the bat good and giving yourself the best chance to move on to go play in single elimination LA.
Buster Posey has never faced Irvin Santana, but he caught Danny Duffy in Duffy's first start in the tournament, a really good one, and also hit a home run in that game. So I guess we'll have to wait and see who's behind the plate tonight. The Dominican roster, the lineup that is, really hasn't changed much. Tony Peña's used the same group, the exception of rotating his DH chair. Wellington Castillo has caught the entire tournament for the Dominicans. Full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes to Hernan Perez. And a 1-2-3 inning in the bottom of the seventh. You only get one chance to make a good first impression. MLB Tonight takes you inside every team's training camp for your first impressions on how teams stack up for the new season. MLB Tonight's 30 clubs in 30 days. Go to MLB Network for the full schedule. It was such a great day to be out there in that park.
It is.
What are we doing inside, Smoltzy?
Oh, I'm going out there in between games.
Are you?
In between games. I'm gonna do a little show and interview people.
You gonna do a clinic out there?
That'll roll down the hill.
Jose Alvarez is the new pitcher for Venezuela in a 10-2 game top of the eighth.
Vargas really needs contact just to feel better about the day.
Three strikeouts and a walk for him this afternoon. Ten runs on 13 hits for Team Puerto Rico today. There's one for him. Leadoff single here in the eighth. Kenny Vargas had been the only member of the Puerto Rico lineup without a base hit today. Again, the reminder that 7 local, 10 o'clock Eastern for the U.S. and Dominican Republic with the big lineups, 2 solid starters and 2 good bullpens as well. I'm not sure how the experts would assign an advantage with the U.S. and the Dominican bullpen being as strong as they are, JP.
Well, Matt, the rest certainly favors the Dominican Republic. Abad, Robles, Betances, Colome, and Familia combined for 4 2/3 scoreless innings against Venezuela earlier this week. But again, they all had the day off yesterday, whereas Andrew Miller threw 15 pitches. Unclear if he'll be available now tonight.
Yeah, I'd be surprised. I think Jim Leland had it in his mind that he wanted to use that card yesterday. Andrew Miller threw the ball well yesterday. He was victimized by a bad hop error behind him. There's a fly ball into right. Carlos Gonzalez with the glasses on is there.
Yeah, Jim Leland brought him in a very difficult situation with 3-0 on the count. It ended up being first and second, nobody out, and really wiggled his way out of it.
Yeah.
You said it, the bad hop error and then the throw is essentially what gave the victory the added runs needed, because U.S. came back for 2 in the ninth to fall 1 short.
Mike Vilas has had a splendid afternoon. A pair of singles, an RBI, a run scored. 3 runs batted in fact. Mike Vilas, who takes a strike. So, JP, if we think about the end of the game, 1-run game, I mean, we've already seen how Tony Peña likes to manage his late innings. What would we expect from the U.S.?
Matt, I think right now it'd probably be Luke Gregerson or perhaps Sam Dyson, who's thrown very well in this tournament.
Back-to-back singles in the eighth.
Dyson again, you might argue, Matt, he's been the U.S.'s most consistent reliever during the course of this tournament so far. He was really a workmanlike effort there in Miami during the first pool. So I would expect either Gregerson or Dyson there in the ninth inning.
Yeah, I think just kind of without making a commitment in either direction, Jim Leland indicated to us yesterday he likes the experience he has with Luke Gregerson. Here's Rene Rivera now with runners aboard and one away. Too quickly to Rivera. We talked about Jose Alvarez in the tournament, the king of the soft contact. Second lowest average opponent's exit velocity the last 2 years in baseball. Only Giants new closer Mark Melancon makes him hit it softer. 1-2.
Baseball throws across his body, so that cuts him in, and it's going to seem a little quicker to the hitter than naturally just a hard throwing traditional guy that throws over the top and straight. Hitters see that a lot easier.
Big wave and a miss by Rivera for out number two. Talk about the starting pitching matchup tonight. It's a good one. Danny Duffy threw the ball very well in his previous WBC start this year. And making his first turn of the tournament is the veteran right-hander Irvin Santana for the DR. There are a couple of U.S. starters or projected starters, presumed starters, that have had some pretty good lines against Irvin Santana. Ian Kinsler's had a lot of success against him. Eric Hosmer with a healthy number against him. And the U.S. will have a chance to avenge this loss. Took a 5-0 lead into the bottom of the sixth inning. Then the Dominican lineup flexed its muscle and ended up with a 7-5 win. And a strike to Roberto Perez.
I think the U.S. has had that in their back pocket ever since that game ended. That little bad taste.
Little chip. Mm-hmm. I would imagine the formula is going to be the same tonight. Trying to get something done against the starter. And no offense to Irvin Santana, but that was a successful approach for the U.S. against Edinson Volquez. They did their damage against the starting pitcher because we know how difficult that Dominican bullpen can be. And as JP points out, they're all available and freshly rested. Chop to third, it eats up Altuve. Vargas is coming around to score.
Different angle, different position. You let that ball kind of eat him up at third base. Admire him from going over there and creating a more comfortable scenario for Lagur, but it is different. The angle of which the ball comes off the bat, everything you're used to reading and seeing at your natural position, second base.
Raymond Fuentes is the batter now. Again, the early termination rules. A 10 or more run lead from the seventh inning on means the game is complete. We'd have to play the bottom half of the inning. It's a 9-run lead for Puerto Rico here with two out. Making that ball a little tougher on Altuve, the fact that he was right in that shadow cutout as well. Here we are at 3:30 local time-ish. And the shadows are starting to play a role. By the time the late game starts, it won't be an issue at all. There's ball four to Fuentes. Bases loaded, a run in, two away. Angel Pagan will be the scheduled hitter, and he's had a nice afternoon. Three hits, including a double and an RBI. And again, base hit here would bring in at least one. And then if Puerto Rico holds in the bottom of the eighth inning, we would have an eight inning final today. No strikes to Angel Pagan. Aviles the runner at third. Perez at second. Fuentes at first with two gone. A ball and a strike.
Well, don't know what Team Puerto Rico will do other than travel to LA. Probably have a small workout over there. Get geared up Tuesday night.
Yeah, there are only two scheduled days off in the whole tournament, and tomorrow's the second of those. Fly ball on the right. Carlos Gonzalez has it to retire the side. To the bottom of the eighth. All Puerto Rico on this day in San Diego. This World Baseball Classic telecast on MLB Network is presented by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. And sponsored in part by Bud Light, famous among friends. And by Wendy's. North County town of Encinitas, beautiful country up there, great coastline. Nice little artist's enclave. Good living. Pitching change for Puerto Rico here in the last of the eighth inning as Emilio Pagan gets some work in here late in a 9-run game. Jesus Flores lifts a fly ball into the corner, and that's where Angel Pagan makes for out number one. Well, we had some questions as to how this would go down today, John, knowing that Puerto Rico had already claimed a spot in the semifinals. Venezuela was a little dinged up without some of its bigger players. The way this game is played in terms of pace would give you no indication that one team's moving on and the other team hasn't won in this bracket. I mean, they're out there playing and getting their work in because, after all, the major league season starts in a couple of weeks.
Yeah, the responsibility to each player is to give their absolute best in preparing them to what you just said, because baseball season for everybody but the last two teams remaining in this classic is what the focus will turn to.
Ender Inciarte is 1-for-3 so far today. Well, the Venezuela side of the scorecard relatively clean, not a lot of activity save the Odor home run, but Puerto Rico just has not stopped hitting in this tournament ever since it began for them in Mexico last week.
Yeah, they've been locked in. They really have. And I think that's the approach you got to have, because when you're in a tournament like this, it comes down to absolutely executing as early as you can and as often. Some guys we've already seen their swing looks good and even great, and some the timing's not there. And then the pitching factor. I mean, when you get guys coming out of the bullpen one inning at a time, in the regular season, you could probably get more expected results. Here, you don't know.
Well, Raymond Fuentes had to make kind of a late adjustment and layout to get to that ball. There are two away here in the eighth.
Yeah, the wind blew it in again, and he gets to it just in a nick of time.
Two gone for Jose Altuve. Well, 11 runs on 15 hits for Puerto Rico on a day that they rest Yadier Molina and Francisco Lindor.
he sat down the whole game.
Yachty?
I've seen him. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm sure he has, but it looks like he's right in there.
Ground ball for Correa. As Juan Astro takes care of the other to wrap up a 1-2-3 inning. We're off to the ninth in a 9-run affair at Petco, all Puerto Rico this afternoon. Start of the ninth inning in an 11-2 ball game. Back with John Smoltz and J.P. Morosi, Matt Vasgersian. Already counting down the minutes to tonight's big showdown between the U.S. and the Dominican Republic. We'll be back with you live for that at 7 o'clock local time, 10 p.m. in the East. Hector Rondon will try to finish things out, at least from the pitching end, for Team Venezuela. Kike Hernandez the first to face him. Correa and Vargas follow here in the top of the ninth. Rondon was a late add to the Venezuela pitching side of things from the designated pitchers pool. Upon request of the Cubs, however, he was not available to go in back-to-back games. Did not have a great outing against the U.S. and wants to finish out his final WBC experience here this year with a clean inning in the ninth.
Yeah, the U.S. touched him up. Kind of like Dominican touched up Miller.
Broken bat hopper out to Altuve at third. One away here, top nine. Been kind of a strange run for the Venezuelan team this year. They were mercy ruled, lost 11-0 as a part of a strange start to the tournament for them. They thought they had been eliminated, but then upon checking rules clarifications, they had a second life and got a chance to play Italy in the play-in game last week to get here. They beat the Italians. Boy, some big scores there. I mean, man, allowing 11, 10, and then 11 runs in their first three games. You give up 10 runs and still win. You're living right there as they defeated Italy in that ridiculous football game. And then they beat Italy in a low-scoring game in the play-in game to get here. They're on the verge of an 0-3 San Diego before they head home.
Italy had the roller coaster of emotions. They come back against. Came back against Mexico, down 4-9, score 5. Mexico didn't record an out. And then they lose 11-10. In an exciting game, and then 4-3. So they were right there at the cusp of heading to San Diego.
Bullpen's been the big problem for them. Bullpen's allowed 9 runs today. The start of the day, their pen had allowed 29 runs in 26 plus innings. So that bullpen ERA jumps up even higher after today's. And there's ball 4 to Correa. Two teams that have qualified for the semifinals that are tuning up in the Cactus League, both in action today. And the Netherlands team is still playing at Salt River Fields, where the Diamondbacks are beating them 12-3. Japan lost to the Cubs by a final of 6-4. It's all boiling down to Los Angeles, and the semifinals start live on MLB Network on Tuesday. The Netherlands and Puerto Rico. And then the winner between tonight's U.S.-Dominican game takes on Japan. Championship game Wednesday night in L.A. Two-run home run for Kenny Vargas. Hey, he's polished up this afternoon after all.
That'll make you forget about 3 strikeouts.
not how you start, it's how you finish. And for Vargas, a hit and a home run in his final two at-bats. Termination rule won't apply because we do have to play the bottom half of the ninth inning. So it's an 11-run game. This was headed towards a laugher after the 5-run seventh. Two games between Puerto Rico and Venezuela in the WBC. And Puerto Rico has outscored them 24-2 in those two games. Two away.
Vargas even runs like Big Poppy. So.
Strikes, the count to Mike Aviles. You know, we'll know that this blonde thing, this the bleach boys, we'll know that it's really hit back home in San Juan when Ricky Martin and Jennifer Lopez make their next concert performances as bleach blondes. Another base hit.
Day.
Mike Aviles wants a deal. He wants to play someplace next year. Man, I mean, it's just turned into a couple of real routes. Rene Rivera takes a strike.
Cast powered by Amazon Web Services going to take us to Mr. Vargas. And that ball was no doubt about it. 114 miles an hour. 380 feet. One of the faster home run exit velocities we've seen in this tournament.
You know, the sabermetrics community talks about the three true outcomes being a walk, strikeout, or a home run, and that just wraps up Kenny's Vargas's day. And maybe that's a good snapshot of what you get from him through the course of a full season. Kind of a switch hitting Puerto Rican version of Adam Dunn. Win with a couple of those guys, you know. You just, I don't think you can win with a roster full of them.
You can, but I don't know how many times you're going to get five at bats in a game to be allowed to strike out three times and hit a home run.
Called strike three to retire the side, not before more big damage. Two-run home run by Kenny's Vargas. And Puerto Rico's three outs away from wrapping it up. Well, Edwin Rodriguez and Team Puerto Rico three outs away from wrapping up an impressive victory and keeping their perfect record unblemished in World Baseball Classic play. J.C. Romero, the veteran, will look to close things out in the last of the ninth. Most recent organized baseball was in 2015 in Long Island. The Independent League. Is that the Ducks? The Long Island Ducks? I believe it is. Someone step on a duck. It's Rougned Odor leading things off in the last of the night.
Odor is responsible for the two runs for Team Venezuela. Two-run homer.
Responsible for the only two runs that Venezuela's scored in almost two complete games against Puerto Rico this year. MLB Tonight follows us, and then we'll be back with you for the big nightcap, the U.S. and the Dominican Republic at 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific. The winner of that one moves on to the tournament. Romero has the little chip shot, and this one gone in the ninth.
Victor could use a hit before he goes back.
Yeah, why not, right?
To Lakeland, Florida.
We'll reset here in the broadcast booth for the nightcap, as they will in the stands. This crowd will clear out. Some of them will come back, I'm quite sure. And we were told as of yesterday that a near sellout crowd was expected. There were game day tickets still available. I do know this, if you're planning on coming downtown for that game later on tonight, leave yourself plenty of time to maneuver through downtown San Diego, because not only is it filled with World Baseball Classic fans, but there's a huge convention down here. And man, I mean, the streets are just overflowing. Fun atmosphere. On the ground is shortstop.
Well, if everything goes to plan, Matty, you're going to be able to make your 4:30 massage.
Yeah.
You ready for game two?
Right.
Tough work, man.
Gonzalez will have one final at bat before he heads back to the Cactus League.
Nine!
No let up by Team Puerto Rico today. As Francisco Lindor shared with J.P. Morosi, rather. Want to stay on the process, and they are undefeated headed to LA. A resounding 13-2 victory for Team Puerto Rico. A great way for them to end their stay in San Diego. They knew they were moving on after beating the U.S. last night. They finished this pool with a win and end San Diego 3-0.
Clearly led by that guy. They were prepared, they executed, and they flat out had their hitting shoes on.
The 2013 runner-up, undefeated in World Baseball Classic play in 2017. And ready for a date with the Kingdom of the Netherlands in Los Angeles in the semis. This award this afternoon's Alfa Romeo Player of the Game. Mike Aviles had a great afternoon. His only appearance here in the San Diego bracket resulted in four hits, three RBIs, keying the charge, and a 13-run, 17-hit attack. this afternoon. Mike Aviles, our Alfa Romeo player of the game.
He's outstanding at the plate, made a nice diving catch in right field. Aviles, that's checking in.
Happy to contribute today and also looking for work. Still one of the unsigned veteran major leaguers making up Team Puerto Rico. Team photo time. Congratulations to Team Puerto Rico, undefeated so far in the tournament and moving on up to Los Angeles for the semis. 13-2, the final score in our opening act from Petco Park today, and still to come the big one. The U.S. and the Dominican Republic at 10 o'clock Eastern, 7 o'clock local time for the right to move on in the tournament. For John Smoltz and John Palmarossi, Matt Vaskersian, thanking you for joining us. We'll be with you later on tonight for the big one. For now, it's MLB Tonight. Back at the MLB Network studios, Scott Braun, take it away.